What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the BTR Garage. We're continuing the project on the BMW M3 or 325IS. A bunch of those upgrades that we're working on before we get the car retuned here, including new oil pressure and temperature sensor, new fuel pressure sensor, new fuel pressure regulator, new injectors, and a few other things as well. CAN lambda for the ECU. But let's go ahead and catch up with where we are. So we have a lot of the car taken apart already. We've got the air intake out, the throttle body moved aside, the fuel lines disconnected from underneath the manifold as well, because we're gonna take off the entire manifold so we can get under there and fix the sensors and the wiring that's down underneath here. It's just much easier to get to if we have the manifold out. Plus it'll make getting the fuel rail and all of that stuff back together. As you can see, we have the fuel rail removed. It's still attached to the electrical connections on the harness. We got to get that taken off, but we're making progress. We got to get this removed from the electrical harness, the injectors, that is. Then we can take the fuel rail back over to the bench and swap out the injectors themselves, get that put back together. We also have to put the new FPR on there too. So we'll get that done and then start moving underneath the intake manifold after we get it taken off, get the old sensors taken out, get the old wiring for the old gauges taken out as well, and start wiring in the new sensors, installing the new sensors, the CAN lambda, and some of the other things that we've got going in the car. So I just had to drain a bunch of fuel out of the fuel rail, even after already draining fuel from the fuel lines where it connects to the return and the fuel filter. I still had fuel inside the fuel rail. So we got that out, didn't make too much of a mess, but now we're gonna take this thing back to the bench here. And first, I think I'm gonna grab a piece of cardboard to throw under the fuel rail just in case any more fuel does leak out. Throw that down there like so. And to get the injectors out of here, they've got these little clips that hold the injector onto the fuel rail. I'm just gonna pop those off of each fuel injector and then we can put the new ones on. And we gotta get this guy off as well, the little circlip or retaining clip that holds the FPR in place. Crazily enough, this is all the fuel pressure regulator is this tiny little guy here. So we'll take it off and show you what the 2.5 bar, or is it 3.5 bar, the higher pressure fuel regulator looks like, and stop dropping stuff on the floor. But let's get these injectors swapped over. So it took a bit of prying to get my little fuel pressure regulator out of the end of the fuel rail. I had to pry it out with a little screwdriver. You can kind of see where I marred it just a tiny bit, but once you get it started, it comes out okay. But if you're actually doing this project, just be really careful pulling that out so you don't damage the fuel rail. And it turns out I actually have a 3.5 bar fuel pressure regulator already in there this whole time. So now I've got a new one. So this is a brand new 3.5 bar. I might as well throw it in since it's brand new. But what we're gonna do is grab some engine oil, fresh engine oil, lubricate all of the O-rings, and then drop the injectors into the fuel rail, and same with the fuel pressure regulator. Then we'll bring the manifold over here and then drop this whole setup with the injectors into the manifold. But let's go ahead and get these installed here. So we have most everything put back together on the fuel rail. As you can see, fuel lines in place. Got the short connecting fuel line over here. I have another one that I got to put together on this side, but I also have to find out how to get this T in the pressured side of the fuel system, because that's where I'm going to stick my fuel pressure sensor, this guy here. So we got to get this in there somewhere, and I haven't quite figured out how we're going to do that yet. I might put it in line right after the fuel filter in the car. We can go check that out actually. So down here, might be able to tee into that and then put my fuel pressure sensor right there, but we got to figure that out before we can go any further. And once I figure that out, I got to start taking everything back out of the inside of the car as well. So remember all of the gauges that we had on the inside here, all of that wiring I got to get taken out, because nothing is going to come into the cabin anymore. So this whole setup right here will go away. All of the gauges and the instrumentation for that will go straight into the Link ECU. And then that's what we'll display on the race dash when we get that. So like I mentioned earlier, everything will go into the dash and no longer be in the gauges on that little panel in the center console. And speaking of the Link ECU, I actually have it out right here. You can take a look at that, see what that actually looks like when it's out of the car. But it fits into the normal BMW ECU case. And here's where we have our ports for our CAN bus. We have two CAN ports. There's one underneath there, and then this sideways one here, or vertical one, and then this here, that big loom is the expansion loom. So all of these wires is what we'll attach our new sensors into. And then the new wideband sensor will actually go into one of those CAN ports that I showed you. I gotta get a different cable and connector for that, but once we have that, we can wire it all into the ECU. All right, so we're gonna wrap up the video at this point. I gotta do some thinking on how we're gonna get that fuel pressure sensor into the engine bay, and then we can start putting things back together. And we have just a couple other things to button up before we can get the car started again. I do gotta install the wideband sensor into the downpipe on the car. There's one in there already for the old AEM gauge, but we got the new CAN Lambda one that we gotta get in there obviously as well. That was this stuff down here. There's the new wideband sensor. But that's it, we're gonna wrap it up. Thanks everybody for watching. If you have any thoughts, comments, or questions, please leave them down below like usual. Stay safe out there. I am checking out. We'll talk to you all next time.